of a dance right here on the hashtag Why in the Morning. And before we get too far, we have an interesting question that we've already asked you on our social media. Ni time ya men kujieleza wakilia ama bado ego about pride inasumbua. And in just a bit, in that, in regard to Mark International Men's Day, of course, it was marked yesterday. At, the theme for this year was zero male suicide. And I'm interested to actually just highlight you some of the themes around that and some of the messages. But I'll get to the messages. There's one that said, Happy International Men's Day. Today, let's celebrate the incredible men who make a positive impact on our lives and the world. And then there's another one that says, to all the amazing men out there, may your day be filled with joy, recognition, and appreciation you truly deserve. Happy International Men's Day. The second last one, it said, Happy Men's Day to all the gentlemen who stand tall with integrity, compassion, and strength. Your influence is extremely invaluable. I think this last one is really powerful. It says, you are the rock in our lives. I guess this came from a woman. You are the rock in our lives, the best husband, father, brother, and the son we could ever wish for. Today, we celebrate you. Happy Men's Day. And we've also asked you on our social media platform, is it wanaume wameanza kulia na kujieleza ukiwa na stress ama pride inasumbua? And joining us live today, we have Edwin Okoth and Jeffrey Ntabo. Karibuni sana. But then ningependa kujua, maybe I'm going to start off with you, Edwin. How did you mark yesterday's International Men's Day? Did it mean something to you? Did you see anything in that regard? Were you celebrated as well?
Okay, yesterday was a really huge day for me. It was also my birthday.
Oh, happy birthday.
Thank you. So, actually, I got calls from all my family members, my dad, my mom, my brothers, and my sister.
Yeah.
Even my brother, who is sitting his national exam, he called me, wished me happy birthday.
Okay. Is he a brother?
Brother's mental, yeah.
Oh, okay.
So, it's really special to me because being born on the same day the world gets to celebrate men is huge for me.
Right.
So I'm really blessed. I have people. I have a good support system.
Yeah.
And that was quite exceptional for me. So I tell you, my men's day was good.
What was the most outstanding message from the calls you received?
From my dad.
Oh, from your dad.
Yeah. You know. Fine. Me and him, we get along so well.
Okay.
So when he comments me on anything, I feel like I'm on the right track.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm doing something good. I feel like he's seeing me. I'm being seen. I'm being heard.
Yeah.
So when I got to talk to my dad, it was the most outstanding thing out of all the messages I got yesterday.
Right. So what did the message say?
In fact, when I woke up and I saw the message,
or texted, or called.
It was a text.
All right.
Yeah. So the text. The text woke me up. Said, "As you turn a year older, I am grateful to have you as my son," which is something many men don't get to experience in their lives.
Right. Exactly.
Either somebody is missing in their lives, a male figure.
Yeah.
But I'm so happy I have a male figure in my life.
Mm-hmm.
I have a dad who cares about me,
yeah.
And. I can't wait for him to see what I have in store for him. You know,
right.
I'll surprise him one day, I'll surprise him every day.
Yeah.
I think it's going to be a good
day. Did you also celebrate him in regards to also Father's Day?
I won't lie.
It was your day,
you. I won't lie to you. I won't lie to you. That's,
yeah.
I was so overjoyed,
mm-hmm.
You know? And I kind of forgot about that.
Okay.
Because it was my day.
It was your day.
Yeah.
How many years younger or older, if you are?
Okay, I'm 23.
Okay, happy birthday.
I turned 23 yesterday, so it's a milestone.
Right.
Because Michael Jordan also wore the number 23, so
his birthday.
Yeah.
So nice. I love the fact that, you know, you related it to your dad, and it's an incredible thing, by the way. Not so many men out here, or boy child in general, to use the word, have fathers who are present, and they are connected with their fathers. And I remember yesterday, I think it's a friend of former colleague who works at Kids FM. I saw him on another TV show, and they were talking about, the topic was about missing fathers in regards to International Men's Day. Today, there's like a huge number of boy child in this city who do not have fathers who care about them or who are connected. Most of them were kicked out. It was like, you're 18, go out and create a life. And a lot for you, like your dad is present and you have that emotional connection that is needed for men in this society today. Incredible. Yeah. Now I'll come back to you in just a bit. What about you, Jeffrey? How was your experience? You know, when I called your name, I remember a producer, Jeffrey. I know. Shout out to you. Good morning. So how was yours and how did you experience it? And what were some of the most outstanding things that you picked out?
Yesterday, I can't lie. Two events a big day for me.
Yeah, why? Why not? What happened?
Because to me, usually during the weekend or yesterday,
yeah,
I was kind of happy.
Oh, look,
so I didn't find that time to celebrate. But there's one special person who reminded me happy Men's Day.
Who is that?
A special someone.
Oh, yeah. It could be a mother, could be a brother still.
No.
Could be a, you know, better house.
Yeah.
Or
yeah.
Better house.
Yeah.
I guess somebody will burn.
Yeah.
A little reminder. And that was incredible. So what was the message? And maybe what one would you have expected for that Men's Day?
Maybe to go out and treat myself, but you know, as a man, you have many things to do. Once you start celebrating some certain days, life won't become easier. Life will just become hard. Okay. So the outstanding message was Happy International Men's Day.
Right.
You are a man of your words.
Oh, nice.
Keep it up.
Clap for yourself.
You're good.
You're a man of your own words. Clap for yourself. But also then, in there, she pointed out his dad, which fathers play a very big role in mentorship for the boy child.
Yeah.
Even that, the biggest problem that they say that is affecting men is men who never had male role models who modeled for them how to become a man, how to grow up as a responsible man. Actually, the whole large scale of masculinity, how do you become a masculine man, that a lot of people never picked up. So I don't know, from you, did you expect also your dad to, I don't know if she's there in your life, is she present? And also presence could be provision and emotional connection and that relationship father to son that a lot of boys are out here like. I don't know, what's yours?
Oh, okay, my dad actually is very present in my life
because
he has been through with me a lot, even in the choices I make in career. But yesterday, I didn't receive anything from him, like a message to congratulate
him. What about you? Did you wish him happy?
No.
Why not? What happened? Why the tension?
Like yesterday, you're always busy.
I'm sure it was Mother's Day.
Very fast. Very fast.
I don't give a presentation. But what is it when it comes to dads? There's always a certain, you know, reluctance. Because there's a time I had a conversation with a friend of mine at a production house, and it was like a group of boys doing aungeleshangi baba zao kabisa. They don't talk to their dads, and their dads don't talk to them. And other they did something, like there's just tension between them and their dad. Sanko na shanga, why is it such a big thing? Boy child na baba. But you would find out na mothers there, like heaven.
Like you see fathers, a father will just show you how life is. At a later time, you congratulate how things to, like mental health. How bora to provide you, on a former poor. The rest, usually our fathers come from a certain generation.
Yeah.
So things are different. Maybe fathers of nowadays, they keep their children to that mental health.
Right.
But the fathers of our generation, oh, they just know my son is living, is eating, is okay, life is good, and he's following everything I'm telling him.
Yeah. Me evil. Matosha. All right.
Yeah.
All right. Let me come back to you, Edwin. What are some of the things, I say, in terms of character that are shaping you? You said you're a media student, meaning you're in campus as well. And yesterday was your birthday. Now, from your father, it's a men's conversation, what are some of the things, or in terms of character, that are shaping you, that you've learned and you picked from your dad, and you say, hey, this is, I've also had stories where, personally, me, at some point, somebody told me, I'm just an exact copy of my dad, rest in peace, though. There's things that you just follow after your father. You know, there's even those that go, your dad was an engineer, you become an engineer. Your dad was a pilot, you also become a pilot. Your dad was a teacher, you become a teacher. But then also individually, character-wise, what are some of the things you picked that I'll share?
To You asked him earlier, why if it was women's International Women's Day?
Yeah. It's Mother's Day.
Mother's Day. Okay, yeah. Okay. Mother's Day. Tribute to be pouring all over for the women. You know, mm-hmm. people are always like praising them. Yeah. You know, my mom did this. You know, mama go everything. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But the same can't happen to the men.
It can't happen to
the men.
Uh-huh. Why not?
Because when you are born as a man, mm-hmm. the world expects you to be strong. Right. The world expects you to be the one that burdens everybody's problems.
Mm-hmm.
Like you are the one, you are the one they have to lean on to,
yeah.
right? So it's never lovey-dovey with the men,
mm-hmm.
you know. The world is never lovey-dovey with the men. The world is never so compassionate to the men as it is with the women.
Yeah.
You know, you hear everybody, activists everywhere, they're like, oh, women should do this.
Yeah.
What about the men?
Ah.
So that's why I'm so grateful to have a father figure in my life.
Yeah.
And back to the question you asked me, yeah?
What are some of the things that
yeah.
he's character-wise
from
him that he does?
So my dad,
yeah.
he tells you things how it is.
Mm-hmm.
He tells you things how they are, you know?
Yeah.
If you are wrong, you're wrong. If you're right, you're right. He won't be like, you do something bad, and he's like, you know, you'll have it next time. Don't stress about it. Don't think too much. He will tell you, this was wrong.
Yeah.
This is the line you should follow,
uh-huh.
and this is the way to go.
Yeah.
Personally, I'd like to have that in my life. You
uh-huh.
know, the courage to tell somebody that you're wrong, you're out of place, you shouldn't do this, you should do this. That's something I really want to take from my father,
uh-huh.
because it keeps a lot of bad energy away from you.
Yeah.
You know, when people know you're straightforward with what you say, with what you do, they wouldn't want to like mess around you. You know,
mm-hmm.
they wouldn't want to mess up or play around with you. You know, play around with your emotions or things like that. So that's something I'd like to take from him.
Mm-hmm.
And another thing I'd like to take away from my father's attributes is his hard work. My father is a hard worker. He makes sure we have everything. You know, it provides as a man, like, you should be able to provide. That is one thing, or another thing, rather, that I'd really like to take away from my dad.
Yep.
Yeah.
When it comes to fatherhood, it's a very big thing. And with the rise of suicide, I was actually getting to that, because the theme was all about suicide. Let me just get it right. Yeah, it was International Day. The theme for 2023 is Zero Male Suicide. Now, let me divert it to you, Jeffrey. When I say Jeffrey again, I'm like, all right. When it comes to the high number of suicides that have been recorded, even according to statistics, I think Kenya was rated second in Africa, I think. This could have been like 2-3 months ago, and I was pointing it out right here on the show. The biggest number of people that, you know, die by suicide are men. And when you look at the problems that fester in between, is because of neglect, abandonment, and some of them trace back to parenting. You know, somebody ran away from home because of trauma. They were hated by their mother. Their father never hated them. Or in short, they come from a broken home where the mother and the father were never together. So the dysfunction started from the mother and the father. And by the time they're out here, the same time chains of dysfunction are still following them, even in workspaces. And somebody was pointing out also, like, you know, your childhood sometimes comes back to your adulthood. If your mother was resentful towards you, you'll date women who are resentful towards you. If you had a resentful father, you also meet resentful, you know, characters in your life. So what do you think makes that thing so common, especially in a day and age like we live in today? And I understand both of you are Gen Z. Maybe you can give us a Gen Z mindset of why young people are committing suicide at such a large scale.
Well, especially men or men. Just in general?
Men.
See, men, first, men don't have a place to run to air out their issues. You see, men, they kind of, they put themselves in a way that, mimi will not say, mimi ito azizi, nisumbua. And you see, these things like childhood trauma,
trauma,
they start when, maybe, in your upbringing, you see, A parent might be maybe disciplining in a certain way,
uh-huh.
but the parent shouldn't say such
uh-huh.
very bad words.
And I mean some certain statements
that... Erikani kukuchapa chapa chape.
Uh-huh.
You see these words, when you akisha kwambia, kwa kuna malinenda. You never make it in life. You're so... Aushiki masomo.
It's a common thing in African.
Yeah, so you see this kind of trauma,
uh-huh.
it will come back to you. At one point in life, maybe when you have a family, you will start acting the same way your father was. Father like son.
Right.
So like, it's a quite recurring.
Mm-hmm.
So you see, yourself already, that's the first step. Isha kuharibu.
Yeah.
Your mindset. So unaona, if life come even to discipline me total by saying mean words,
yeah.
then let me do what I've been taught.
Mm-hmm.
You see?
Yeah.
So men don't have a place to run.
So
if men were uh-huh. kind of open to other men, like ladies, the way they open up to other ladies,
mm-hmm. then in short, men are not expressive.
Yeah.
They rarely do that.
The one who opens up their tumblers,
right?
Weak.
Your tumblers weak.
Yeah.
But then I believe we can also define a weak man, because Andrew Kibe is very loud on the conversations about weak men, you know. So maybe we can define who is a weak man. maybe we could be victimizing people and people are dying and hurting in the number of be termed as a weak person. Maybe if I could have come out and said I had a problem, negasaidiwa, and whoever would have had you and then you're cross.
Mm.
Other than dying slowly and in the number of you be weak by talking about
so
it.
So weak in a negative manner or in a positive
weak
manner.
Definitely weak is not
like see, according to the society, I'm according to...
Even according to your understanding.
Oh, a weak man.
A weak man, and according to the things you
have. A weak man is a man that can't handle his issues.
A man who can't handle his issues.
Yeah.
Okay.
He's always... A man shouldn't be an introvert.
A man shouldn't be an introvert.
Yeah.
Okay.
Once you become an introvert, then issues. Now, a man who is an extrovert, in his life, doesn't have many issues. But once you start, see, upon the depression, so a weak man can't handle his issues.
Mm-hmm.
How will he face the problem? Yeah, because he could be featured for drugs, maybe something else that will keep his mind off.
Oh.
We should just face the problem the way it is and find solutions.
Okay.
That's how I can define a weak man.
Right, I'd also love to hear this. Who is a weak man according to you? And I don't know if you're also a fan of Andrew Kibe, or if you know him. Have you ever heard of Andrew Kibe?
Yeah, you know Andrew Kibe.
Okay.
I've heard of Andrew Kibe.
Okay.
Andrew Kibe is everywhere.
Right. Yeah. All right. Do you believe in his ideology? So
okay.
You had a very good explanation. Now, what is yours?
The term weak man is really subjective, you know? My views may differ from his.
Okay.
My views may differ from yours or anybody else.
Yeah. But that doesn't make you wrong anyway.
Yeah, it's subjective. That's why I said it's subjective. It's an opinion. Yeah.
Right.
To put it like that, it's an opinion.
Mm-hmm.
So, you want me to define a weak man in my perspective.
Yes.
So, for me, a weak man is somebody who can, who runs away from his responsibilities.
Mm-hmm.
You don't face your fears, you're a weak man. You don't provide when you're needed to provide. You're a weak man. You don't come through clutch. Yeah?
What if you don't have resources to provide and you're expected to? Does that automatically make you, render you disabled? Financially disabled. You're disabled.
So you see, you see, the way you're defined in terms of providing, that's already, if you don't have any means to provide, that's depression already.
Uh-huh.
So you shouldn't define a weak man in terms of maybe his responsibility in certain ways like leadership and managing things. But in terms of resources,
It's not always guaranteed to have the means. Okay, continue. I love your explanation.
That's why I said it's an opinion.
Right.
It's subjective. You can think the opposite way. I can think the other way.
Yeah. And Alea, you were mentioning...
You run away from your responsibilities.
When needed to
you're a weak man. You can't provide when you're needed to. Because everything is planned for, right?
Uh-huh.
If you can't tell me you have a family,
right.
But you don't want to provide for them, Doctor, my point, something that I, we are not well off in my family, but my dad provides for us. He makes sure that we have a little, if it's not too much, a little is enough, right?
Yeah.
So just provide.
Yeah.
Okay. Just provide for the people that you brought into the world. Provide to the people that that depend on you.
Mm-hmm.
Even if it's a little, people will be appreciating.
Yeah.
It doesn't have to be something, you know, exquisite, something over the top.
Mm-hmm.
But just, even if it's a little, just provide.
Yeah.
Okay. So that's my definition of a weak man.
Okay.
As of now, I'm a weak man. Because I can't provide for people. Yeah, because I can't provide. I'm at the weakest right now because I can't provide.
How about you say you are at your most vulnerable and unproductive?
Okay. Okay. That can be a substitute for the word weak man. Yeah. I'm so unproductive.
And you are not productive.
Yeah, I'm not feeding anybody. Sometimes I run from my responsibilities. Sometimes I don't want to face my fears. It's all about in the, you know, the man context. You've got so much going on that you can't face other issues head on. It makes you weak. You know, if it makes you weak, depression creeps in. You know, you're like, okay, the world perceives me in this way. The world views me in this way. You know, they think I'm a failure. They're stamping.
I remember something that you pointed about.
Yeah.
I mean, a men's WhatsApp group, it's actually about men and mental health. And somebody yesterday shared a screenshot on, let me just get it in SAP. I think I got it here. It is. Okay, where is it? Log online. I got it. So it says, let me get back to it. Let me scroll up very fast. Right, it is. So it says, men today are suffering from issues that no one talks about. And they gave three. Number one is low self-esteem. The second one is masturbation. The third one is obesity. And the fourth one is porn. And he offered a book to help that called The Chad Mindset. A Chad is a man who is charming and super sweet to the eye. He's like a personality of TV. You want to be likable and suited to anyone. So you appeal to both men and women.
Yeah.
Thus, I think chad is an adjective word in English to define a sweet man. Sweet is the word. So they've offered this book called The Chad Mindset to help men recover from low self-esteem, masturbation, obesity, and porn. Do you think those are the main problems? I mean, let me shift it to you, Jeffrey. Do you think those are some of the main common problems that men suffer in the society we live in today? And have you ever suffered from any of those either?
Maybe low self-esteem.
Uh-huh. What would be the cause of low self-esteem to you?
To me?
Yes.
You may find I had planned for something. I had already arranged everything, the resources, like everything. But in the end, I didn't receive what I wanted. Like, I didn't get the outcome. So, the next time, I didn't have that esteem to start something else. So I just decided to do away with it.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Maybe you can also get to define what is self-esteem for a man. Among these problems, porn, masturbation, obesity, do you feel like, and low self-esteem, do you feel like they're the main challenges men are facing today in this modern day world we live in?
Okay.
Yeah. So the question is...
Okay. I will be lying to you.
Yeah.
If I come here as a man and tell you that list, nothing has phased me in that list.
Yeah.
I have
apart from obesity, because obesity.
Okay. that's why I'm saying I'd be lying if I say none of the issues raised there affected me.
Okay.
When you're raised, when you go to a boarding school of boys, and you are not of that size, you know the size I'm talking about.
So many same sex.
Yeah, you know.
Okay.
You're not of that size. What keeps you going in high school, Neo?
Why would you until watch porn?
I don't know how it reached school. I don't know. Since you are since you in Nifika, but in Nifika, something wanafawa were digging to
okay. into school okay. to find out.
I'm not saying they should do it. Leave the boys be.
Leave the boys be. That's what you're saying.
Leave the boys be. But that meaning adult yeah. adult films.
Yeah.
Pony really vulgar. Adult films.
Okay.
Every boy that is in high school and that was a boy school, that was a boarding, I'm sure they've seen it.
Are you really sure?
I'm sure.
Like,
okay. Maybe I'm stereotyping to Shule to...
It was common in your school?
Yeah, in Ikua.
Okay, there were issues then.
There were issues about
they even came out to the administration.
Ukienda Instagram, you scroll the reels, you scroll the reels. Utafika mahali utapata. Pornography si lazima ikue iyo nini.
There's levels.
There's levels.
Wild porn.
Exactly.
And this is a topic that people shy away to talk about.
Yeah, so... Eco. Yeah. You know, when you go to Instagram, you go to all these social media platforms. There's somebody who is of not, I think he's not of sound mind. Lazima kaweka tu kitu hapo, akifanya vitu zake. And,
so you become addicted.
You become addicted. The dopamine effect.
Masturbation. Porn that leads to masturbation.
Exactly. One thing leads to the other. Unajipata tu kwa hapo. Media, nini, okay.
Like, okay. And low self-esteem before we get to you, Jeffrey. Low self-esteem. Okay. But all of this can also lead to self-esteem.
Yeah.
Porn connects with masturbation and that connects to low self-esteem.
Yeah.
Or low self-esteem leading to porn and then masturbation.
They are, networks are prophetic. They're leaning on each other. They eat from each other, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So
how can men heal from this and how did you heal from this?
It's in the mindset. Uh-huh. The mindset.
Okay.
You're like, I want to do this. Mm-hmm. Don't run away from your fears. Attack them head on. Where end up with them, iki tu, me na ichuja. I don't need it in my life. I need ID.
And how do you reach to that division of saying iki tu? Of course, lazima it's a effect.
Yeah.
And you can see it's affecting some facets of your life.
Yeah.
It's this.
Yeah.
So how do you arrive at that? For any man who is watching and is affected by low self-esteem, masturbation, and porn, how can they get deliverance from this?
Yeah, you just set a goal. Yeah?
You set a goal.
Yeah. Just be honest with yourself. Have a conversation with yourself. Jiongeleshe. Watu watafikiria wewe ni mwenda, lakini wewe jiongeleshe. Wewe jiambie, hii kitu inanisumbua.
Yeah.
I need to do away with it. Juu nikienda huko nje, nimekaa tu kwa kona. Hata si bongi na mabeshi. I don't talk to my friends.
Yeah.
Like, I have this guilt. They will shame me. If they know about it, just talk to yourself. Because as a man, the society doesn't offer you so many choices outside yourself. You have yourself.
Exactly.
I said, you tell yourself, I really need this. I really need to get to this.
Yeah.
And you know, even if you need to do it, just kuna settings for phone that really keep you away from adult content. Just eka hizo settings. The algorithm will not show you pornographic items for the rest of your life. We katu kimasomaso. Yani, just be a man.
Yeah.
Tell yourself, I need to do this.
Did you hear from all of them?
Exactly.
Exactly.
Miniko sa. Settings nikonazo kwa simu za niki backslide.
This is a big problem. Not just even in Kenya or Africa in general, even in overseas countries, statistics say those are the main.
Yeah.
Apart from financial issues, in fact, you get the upper list though. And just for you are burning.
Let me tell you something.
Yeah.
Let me talk from my perspective.
Yeah, please go ahead.
That adult, whatever, that pornography is a stage.
Oh, it's a stage?
Yeah.
So you feel like it's
no.
a stage?
No. So every...
Even
for
everyone.
Guy, a boy.
Yeah.
A man. It's a stage.
Okay.
Okay.
So for you, you believe everyone who is a male person has right porn or has had an addiction?
Huh. It's wrong. But you see, once after it starts early, primary. You see, once you start blossoming, once you start the adolescent stage,
right.
You want to discover, you want to discover what is going on. Like, if I treat my body,
you become experimental and curious, and curiosity leads to discovering these things.
It doesn't necessarily to be experimental.
Mm-hmm.
You just want to see the things you learn if it's true.
Working on your body now.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And you see, the way to handle such, by the way, one, don't allow yourself to be idle. Just find something to do. Play football. Like, just find something to do that keeps your mind busy. Not necessarily to hustle.
You can be busy and multitasking.
No, no.
You can multitask. Like, I know someone who, like, they're watching three, like, and they're going to go to a video, going to YouTube, or going to blog.
They're going to see.
Yeah. So, I'm going to touch na everything yake.
Another thing, avoid cursing siku if it's daytime. Avoid being alone.
So avoid being alone.
Yeah.
Avoid being idle.
Yeah. Because ukisema you change the settings,
yeah,
there are temptations. There's a part of the settings kwa simu, but kwa lati.
Yeah.
Yeah. Ama you find a certain station, nekango maine, ikona search adult content. So kitu kwanza, as I said, avoid being idle.
Yeah.
Uskai peke yako. Kiata to God. God is there. God can do wonders. Yeah. Who can go to God?
Save me.
Just let me abstain. If you feel, to the moment you feel you want to try that thing,
yeah,
call God.
Sin has a power that keeps on calling.
Yeah.
On the website.
It has only one gope. There's that deal. You can go to approach that website. You know, you can battery that thing.
But what if just reaching out to you, like you have a dad, why couldn't you reach out to your dad and told your dad, hey dad, by the way, maybe I'm watching videos, and these videos are consuming me, and I'm very soon off. Why was it not easy to open up, since it's a man opening up to, it's a father's son? Tell your dad, dad, I'm screwed up, and I need your help.
You know what?
What would have been the
could have
used to you?
Kuna vitu unazambia mamako.
But he's your father.
No.
He's your mother.
Labda a white setting. Labda you're a white
a white family. Why do African parents make it so hard for their sons to tell them their issue?
I think
might you be considered also a weak child?
I think it's something carried on from generation to generation. You know, if my father never taught me, you watch movies. Yeah,
right.
And you see, it's all Western settings.
Yes. The only son is coming out as gay today.
Okay, yeah. The parents are like, I see looking at that lady, I see looking at that girl in your class. What do you feel?
Yeah.
You know?
And then they,
you can never
they drop a bombshell.
Yeah, you can never witness that in an African setting.
Why?
It's the norms, you know, the our beliefs. Everything that we carry from generation to generation, we don't talk about certain things like relationships in teens, you know, in teenagers. They
in fact, sex and relationships. That's the word.
That is never
relationships too, because definitely, like you said, you are doing things.
Yeah.
You're doing.
Yeah.
And why is it not so easy to have such a conversation? For example, would you have that conversation with your dad?
No.
Why not? What will prevent you? Because of the answer, the fear of just, like your dad getting shocked, like, you, my son, you are doing it. You, where were you in to the Kuzana?
I think I'll disappoint him.
Uh-huh.
But
what
I'll
is
feel
the worst that can happen if your dad gets disappointed? Heart attack?
Okay.
God forbid that.
God forbid that, yeah. So, I can't imagine a scenario like that, because I would never... You know, I would never. I would at this age, if yeah. If I had kids, God willingly, if I love kids, I wouldn't even expect them to come to me with such issues.
Why?
Because it's where I'm from. You know, it's where I've been. It's where I'm from. We don't talk about this thing. You know, if they come to me with those issues, I'll be glad to, you know, address them. Because I'll feel like they trust in me, they think I can help them, and I'll try my best to guide them, you know, how I beat it, or how I came to pass through it,
yeah.
What got me through it, you know, the mindset I had, I'll be glad to coach them on that matter.
But now that you've admitted you suffered, that means everybody who's watching.
Everybody has suffered. Even my boys, they know.
Didn't hear you say you suffered from this, yeah?
Yes, you have said it sustained. Before you talk to your dad,
right?
You yourself having that conversation with you and yourself, like, yeah. Watching back. Who is you wanna feel guilty? So I don't wanna come over with Jambia. What about the dad? Though the dad had a major role in Kukataza, come and see, for example, me, my dad.
Yeah.
When I was in my childhood. Mm-hmm. You start to watch movie as a family.
Yeah.
There are certain scenes with Kiona. Zimayo TV. Next time you support him, make a search program. So you see. So from that, I'm going to buy an amna watch.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But you one-on-one.
Yeah.
It's kind of hard.
Yeah.
Unless maybe go on a spiritual father.
Mm.
Yeah. But the dad.
See, you could not really tell your own black father and tell it to a
stranger. Hearing to Wednesday.
Funny. Let me just read something comments here. Kando Maina says, good morning. The question is, siku hizi wanaume wanajeleza na kulia ama bado wananyamazia vitu? Do your pride, okay? Kando Maina says, good morning. Good morning. Jerry Vance anasema, good morning. Present from the Muru. Looking for a comment that's responding to the question. Albin Katoniki Salano, watching live from Vihiga Center. Russ Selegi Waylas, good morning. Well represented in from KC, Nyanchua, Massive Boakire. I know that's how you say good morning. Catherine Shikona Sema Kaganda, Muranga Tukondakas. I'm looking for a comment. Right, this one. It says, Dennis Nyongesa anasema, natazama nikiwa na mwezi in Bungoma County. Wanaume kulialio kwa zamani squeezy. Windi vichanjanga hatu tishu ngo. I love that. Mwangi OG anasema, hello, good morning. Looking from Muranga. Ni kama OG. Mimi kama OG sasa yeye. Kama OG ni ngumu kujieleza. Akivia in fact. Long live the clan ya magangsta.
Mm-hmm.
Moses Wekesa anasema, utanzaje kulia na wewe ni mwanaume in the first place. Let me tell you, now that I've just brought it, I think 40, alright, we're just about to go. When I lost my dad, I cried like a stupid baby. And I cried because my dad was abducted and tortured. And I think there's somebody who gave me a side eye, like, really, you cried as a man? So I really don't know. Can pain cause someone to cry? And does it vary? Like, you're expected to be strong here, and here not expected to cry. Especially now that the question is about crying.
If I were you, it's not right, but I'd wish pain on the person who said I do. You know, they don't know what you're going through. Losing your father, like, it's your best friend, you know? The first male person that you had a conversation with, you know, you lost your father, and somebody's I'd wish pain on them, you know.
You'd wish pain on them.
Times two, because because it's really absurd for somebody to judge you when you're grieving. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I personally really cry in funerals.
You cry in funerals.
But
you know, Luyas and Jalus have that crying thingy,
bro.
It's like a whole event.
I try, because the thought of this person, you are never going to see them again. Mm. You know, you were just talking to them like some 2 weeks ago.
Right?
Yeah, you were on a call.
Kibongajana leo menda, you know.
Menda.
It's shocking and painful.
And you're like, maybe I didn't get to tell you something that I really had, you know. I didn't get to experience something so special with you that I was planning. You didn't see me at my prime, you know. And you've never going to see me again. I'll advise you, just cry.
You'd advise me to cry.
Yeah.
What about you, Jeffrey? Would you cry? Have you ever cried?
Yeah. Do you cry?
There is
experience that made me really cry.
Like tears. Only someone in
here. Yeah. Agora com pincha, agora com barabara com
a gente revia machos,
nada tudo de flow, nada tudo de flow,
right?
Cause the experience was,
what if someone gives you a side eye, like,
bana isso mais já cobana,
yeah?
E agora me queria outra coisa, ele se angou e dizia que ele voltou. This is 31st, the beginning, then December 31st,
yeah.
Então ele quando me tocou job, nilikuwa nimetoka job hiyo usiku ndio niende home
right. Yeah.
So there was a friend tulikuwa tunaishi naye, me my bro and that friend
right.
So imagine tarehe moja hiyo usiku kufika tarehe moja we found our friend dead. Tulipata amekufa, lakini kaa alikuwa mgonjwa, so tukapata alituacha time tunampeleka usiku. So you know kitu nifanya kabisa, sikuficha. So from that I understand what people go through. So mimi nikiona mwanaume analia siwezi kujudge, because I understand I've been there.
Okay. Apart from financial issues, I think we've talked about a lot. Some of the main problems men go through.
Yeah.
One of them includes financial issues. I don't know. Let me see if I can get a comment on X. You got him as locked, yes? Let me see. I'm going to say, thank you for the share. Drop me. Again, then now, bye. Cheers, and yeah, definitely that's a request. They'll play it. All right. I think you can see our social media very fast, and then we take a break. We'll come back in just a bit. Your handles?
IG, Geoffrey Ntabo 202, and Facebook, Geoffrey Ntabo. That's all.
I'm on Twitter. I'm not on the other social media platforms. I'm on Twitter at Eddie Nocott. That's my Twitter handle.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. That was blowing up my ear. But it's all right though. All right. Let me sample another comment before we exit. And you guys maybe as we sample feedback here as it keeps on loading. What do you think? Some of the things that any man who is struggling in their life right now, the things that they should do to ensure they are at peace mentally, because the suicide, even the team was also suicide, zero suicide prevention.
Yeah.
What are some of the things that you guys feel and you'd recommend anyone, especially a man who's been watching right now, that this is what you should do to live a peaceful life, a fulfilling life, if you're struggling with stories of affirmation? But there's men who've never been affirmed, like, and are struggling with stories of self-doubt, self-esteem, what can they do
as
to just hug and live a peaceful life?
As a man, you learn to appreciate yourself. I think you put that little amount of money, for example, you're hustling, just do something for yourself. Don't live in a lifestyle of your own. You can only accept and learn to appreciate yourself to remain the one. Now, if you may shank over the good, I'm a similar wish in my heart.
Yeah. I have a strong connection to music.
Okay.
So when I'm feeling down,
it's your therapy.
It's my therapy. When I'm feeling down, I just put on some Christina Shusho. I just close your eyes and you wake up 30 minutes, you're like, okay.
Let it talk. Let it talk over you.
Yeah, thank you, Rose, for talking to the devil.
Uh-huh.
He's now out of me.
Yeah.
So tomorrow is never guaranteed. So the most important things are the relationships that we build now. We're living in the now, right?
Yeah.
So build relationships as much as you can.
Right.
Like right now, I've known Geoffrey.
Mm-hmm.
I might check his contact and we link. You know, because he shares my views, I share his views. Yeah, we almost think alike. Huh?
Yeah.
So just have a relationship with people that value you. And like I have friends who I go to visit from time to time, and they're like, we laugh at our problems, you know. It's not that serious, you know. It's that serious. Just have a laugh or two a day, and you'll be right.
This one is an interesting one.
Yeah.
From the Mexico group, I pointed. Is LGBTQ one of the problems facing men in the society today? Is it an option? Is it a disease? Is it a mental health disorder? Is it a choice? LGBTQ.
It's a choice.
Oh, to use a choice, it's not a problem.
It's a problem. It is a choice. It's a mental health disorder.
Yeah. Okay. What about you?
You were so strong on that point. it's a menace. The world is disorderly. We don't know where we are headed. It's so absurd that somebody just comes out of the blue and says, oh, come on, you are a man, fight your demons. Eh? You understand what I'm saying? You are a man, fight your demons. Don't let your demons win. Seek spiritual guidance. Don't just give up easily, you know. You are letting the main cohort down, you know. It's bad. But yeah. I think it's a mindset.
It's a mindset.
It's a mindset. Can it
be resolved now that it's...
No, it cannot. Imechukua mkondo wake, it's going.
Is it imechukua mkondo wake or the people that are funding things?
The conspiracy theorists are saying it's funded, so you don't know what to believe. You're like, there's some people, you know, pushing the agenda, you know, paying people to push the agenda. So you can't fight, the puppet masters, you know. You can't fight the puppets and if the puppet master is too strong to be fought, you leave the issue as it is. You can't do anything about it.
Okay, but you guys are determined to have a solution.
Just people should just embrace our culture.
Yeah. Okay.
And Kenyan people just embrace our culture. Live with that culture because it's a problem. Necessarily we can't stop because it's already in us. In the society, what we can do is to put measures to curb or to control or to reduce the
The Supreme Court that ruled in favor of it and they even called on the church to say something about it.
They should put programs to just encourage people.
But let me throw a spanner in the works before we disappear off the air. What if your sister or your brother turned out to have had such an experience? What would you do? Would you tell her to die with it, take him or her for deliverance to the nearest
Let me think
to slap the hell out of his or her spirit?
When issues like that hit close to home, it's the same as losing someone dear, so dear to you. They hold a gun to your head and say, shoot your brother. You will not do it.
So you guys are saying it's a very
your close family member.
I'm glad it hasn't affected me.
Yeah, I'll take
but
you to jail.
You never know if somebody is doing whatever they do.
I mean, I'll take you to jail.
Unasema hivyo before ikufikie. Bana ikishafika tu hivi, you know? Ikishafika tu hivi, you are so stressed out. It's your brother, it's your sister. You don't know what to do about it.
But
you love these people so dearly, you don't want to lose them, you don't want to drive them away from you.
Being fan, in short.
But on a serious note,
yeah,
I'll try to talk to you.
Yeah.
I'll tell the family members to try to talk to you. If that's your path, you have decided to mejaribu sila kitu umekata, then so be it. Live your life.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, and I think we'll end it from there. You guys have said your social media and everything. So it's just time for us to exit. By the way, thank you so much for watching. And we definitely wish it in the beginning of the show, we're wishing a happy International Men's Day to anyone who feels like a man, but... And it may change. Happy International Men's Day to all the men who are responsible and doing their outright best to be at their level best in life because it ain't easy to be a man. At Vital Support Channel, I'm Brian Self 101. We'll see you definitely tomorrow for Health and Entrepreneurship Tuesday. Have a fantastic Monday. See you tomorrow.